So, you know, it is never fun to be stuck at home with a stomach ache or even worse in the hospital. But you may not realize a gastrointestinal problem looks different in women than men. Dr. Rohini Vanga is here to explain the differences. She is with Alamance Gastroenterology, Burlington, and a member of the Cone Health Medical Group. She is a board certified in internal medicine, gastroenterology, and hepatology too. Good morning.
Good morning.
So let's talk a little bit about the common problems that women suffer, because some stomach aches, we just say, oh, it's just a stomach ache. It's just a stomach ache. But a lot of times that's not just what it is, right?
That is absolutely right. There are several common conditions that women encounter from the GI tract standpoint. And the most common conditions are GERD, which is gastroesophageal reflux disease, commonly referred to as heartburn. Mm-hmm. The next common condition is dyspepsia, which is commonly referred to as indigestion, uh-huh. Chronic constipation, irritable bowel syndrome, which is a functional GI disorder, and it is the delayed emptying of the large intestine primarily, uh-huh. Or could be the faster emptying of the large intestine. Inflammatory bowel disease, which is the inflammation in the GI tract, could be Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis, and symptomatic hemorrhoids. The third most common cancer in women, which is a colon cancer.
So let's talk a little bit about some of these. Like GERD, you said, was like heartburn and indigestion or regurgitation. But things like dyspepsia, what is that?
So dyspepsia is primarily the patients present with abdominal pain, mm-hmm. in the upper abdomen, or burning sensation in the stomach, early satiety, which is a fullness of the stomach, nausea, and bloating.
So what do you do for something like that?
There are several treatment modalities that are available, and could be over-the-counter or a prescription medication, and dietary modification. There are some stress relaxation techniques that play a very key role in dyspepsia. And there are different types of dyspepsia. If mm-hmm. it's a functional dyspepsia, then these modalities help. If the dyspepsia is related to ulcers or any bacterial infection called Helicobacter pylori, then it needs an endoscopy or other tests in order to diagnose what the cause of the dyspepsia.
So let's talk about two of the other two that we've heard probably a lot about, IBS and IBD, because a lot of people, you know, have heard about them and maybe know women who suffer from it.
It is very important to recognize the difference between IBS and IBD, which often gets confused.
Yeah.
IBS is irritable bowel syndrome, which is just a functional disorder of the GI tract. There is no actual structural damage that's occurring in the GI tract. Inflammatory bowel disease is the inflammation in the entire GI tract, anywhere from mouth to the bottom to the anus and the rectum. Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis, it is important to differentiate, because early treatment, early diagnosis, and the prompt treatment is the key in managing IBD.
Yeah, because in some cases with IBD, I mean, surgery has to come.
Absolutely.
And you want to
try. It goes that far.
Yeah, you want to try to prevent that. So when women start having these symptoms, that some of them that you have discussed, what should we do?
So there are some remedies that are available. First, importantly, to recognize if it's just a functional disorder, mm-hmm. or if it's something really pathologic going on. If it is a functional disorder, for example, there are over-the-counter medications and there are certain prescription medications that we could try. Identifying the dietary triggers are the key. Stress is a big factor in
big
functional
factor.
GI disorders, and stress relaxation techniques, exercise, adequate sleep are the key.
All right. This has been very informative. You've given us a lot of information this morning. You know, if you want to learn more about some of these, especially about colonoscopies and illnesses related to your digestive system online, you can go to conehealth.com/gastroenterology. There's also an online video for those who suffer from irritable bowel syndrome. You can find that video at conehealth.com/wellness-on-demand. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you. My pleasure.
House Call on Fox 8 is sponsored by Cone Health.